All right, I think with that, we are good to go. We got the Mexican runner up here. He's going to be giving us a run first of Cuphead.
Yeah, known to be one of the hardest boss-centered video games of all time. And the Mexican runner known to be one of the greatest gamers of all time. Kick it off, man.
Yeah, let's hear it one more time.
Round of applause. TMR
and Cuphead.
There we go.
Hello, hello, hello. How is everybody doing tonight?
Woo!
I didn't hear anything. How is everybody doing tonight?
Now you can hear it.
Okay, so which is the table that has more drunk people? There's no table? Okay. Well, you have time, so I'm going to be playing this game that is called Cuphead. This game is really amazing. As you can see, it's two guys that they have a really nice choreography. They're very sync. The one in the left with the red shorts is called Cuphead. The one in the right side is, I believe it's his brother. I'm not very sure, but that guy is Mugman. So this game came out in 2017, if I remember correctly. And as my friend said, it was it's very heavy, boss concentrated. I hope the controllers are fine. Otherwise, we will have to see what's going to happen. So to start the round, I would like the crowd to count down from five. So let's go. Five.
Five.
Four. Three, two, one, go!
Boom, Cuphead. So the game, it starts with the book, like every fairy tale.
Once upon a time, there was a casino, and there were some people playing.
Yeah, just like in Vegas, right?
Yeah, we got a casino here.
Yeah. So, wow, well, I don't know, like, I'm sure very people is familiarized with these dice, and with that, who here has lost due to a bad throw I don't know what is the name of
that's
that.
That's a craps table.
It's a craps table.
Who here's a fan of craps? Anyone? Yeah? Now, who lost way too much money in craps? I know I did. I did. That's with me.
Just the roll of the dice.
Okay, so here we have the old man that is giving us a potion, the blue potion. I'm still not sure what it does, but clearly it just gives you magical effects. So I'm going to start going to the tutorial just for the memes. You know, like this level, it can take several times. Oh, I forgot, man. I forgot. I don't know how to cross this wall. Huh.
How would we know?
Yeah, when this game came out, there was a reviewer of games that couldn't make it past the first wall, and that was pretty embarrassing. He got a lot of critics on the internet. But yeah, this game, it is a masterpiece, and it's also like something amazing for the people who like retro gaming, because it's like a monument, right? Like, this game is extremely difficult. And talking about difficulty, this is one of the run and gun stages, and the only one that I will be doing. This game is notoriously hard, and the first version of the game that came out, it had some glitches that I'm gonna be abusing during the run. Like, so far I have not used one, but the one that you're gonna see very soon, hopefully I can pull it off. Because it is a little bit difficult. I need to clip in the corner here. Uh-oh.
Nice.
Oh, you don't know what... No, this is fine.
This is fine.
This is fine. Everything right under control. Yeah. Okay. This is it. So basically, like in Mario Bros. 1, you can clip on the corners. If you dash right in the corner, it just lets you pass down there. I mean, you can easily kill that enemy as well, but I wanted to show you that little trick. So right, the reason why I went there is just to get some money, so now I can go to the shop, and here we have
this guy. Welcome.
So I'm gonna buy the roundabout, and I'm gonna use a glitch that it exits me of the shop, and also I bought the lover right after. So right now I'm just gonna keep it. I believe I did it. Yeah, I did it. So I'm going to go to the very first boss. I'm playing the legacy version, so the very first trick that we have is the weapon swap glitch. So basically with the weapon swap, you can swap like all the time, and the faster you do it, the faster you shoot one and another weapon that you use. So I also have special attacks like these ones that I'm gonna show, like that one. That is the lower, not the roundabout special attack. Then we have the lower one, but it is a little bit tricky to see. And that was the boss, right? Very hard game, clearly.
You know, it says a knockout at the end of every boss. Maybe we can actually get everybody to cheer along with that one, yeah? What do you guys think?
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the category you're running is all bosses, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
This is all bosses. So I technically didn't have to go to the run and gun level, but I went for the money because buying these two weapons, it let me kill the bosses very fast. So that is what I'm doing.
So many running guns are required for this category. Here you go. There's a lot of influence in this game development. Everything from Street Fighter to Silly Symphonies is heavily, heavily influenced. And you can see a lot of this in this fight in particular. If you think you see a head nod to something that you played before, chances are you're correct.
Yeah. Sometimes it's possible to skip certain phases in this game. You're gonna see something pretty cool in this game that you need to make certain amount of damage in order to trigger the next transformation of the boss. So hold on. It's too many things. So once you trigger the next transformation of the boss, a new kind of a health bar appears on the boss. But what happens?
Knockout!
But what happens once you trigger one and the boss hasn't transitioned and you kill that animation, then the game just doesn't know what to do and it's gonna glitch the hell out. I'm gonna abuse that in certain bosses and you're gonna see the game just don't know what to do, what to spell. That is something that the programmers didn't have in mind when they did the game, but of course they released newer patches and they fixed that. So the next boss is Cuphead Le Grande. For those of you RPG lovers, this got some inspiration in those Dragon Warrior games and many others.
Wow.
Knockout! So that was the third boss.
Very fast, finally.
So the story of the game we didn't mention. The game is the brothers, the Cuphead brothers, I will call them. Well, I don't even know if they have a surname, but
Moldenhauer.
Cuphead Moldenhauer is the surname? Okay, so that it happens to be also the name of the creators of the game, right?
Yes, yeah, that's what I was saying. Okay. The developers last name.
So the story, the brothers, Morden Howard, they went to a casino, and they were in a winning streak, and they got greedy. So the devil told them, oh, if you win this last one, then you can have all my money, but if you lose, I will have your soul. So that's a pretty bad story. For this fight, I'm gonna try to get intentional hit, and hopefully I can get a glitch that is not gonna happen anymore because it's a very precise glitch, so I needed the help, the little thing that you can parry. So there is pink objects in the game that you can parry, and those objects are pretty cool because in the bottom left I have cards. So once a card show up, like Dire, I can throw like a special attack. Just like that, I did. Oh, wow. I need to be careful. Oh, my God. Sorry for the screams. It just sometimes gets intense in here. So sometimes I try to shoot those missiles in order to make the most damage that I can. So as you can see, this game is great in the animations it has. It just shines on that. Oh, okay, so here we have a tricky section, those UFOs, the actual yellow ones. Oh, wait, what? Okay, the yellow ones are like from long distance, the red ones, the
Knockout. There's so much going on screen.
Yeah. So this game, this game was inspired in the 1930s drawing.
1930s animation.
Animation.
Style.
Yeah. And I have to say, like, they totally nailed it. It just feels like you're playing a cartoon but with a controller, right?
Oh, absolutely. Well, a lot of these animations were hand-drawn cells as well. Like, they are actual animations.
Here we have a boss that looks pretty cute, but then it turns into a really bad one. So this one is a tricky boss, usually, but because I'm using the weapon swap glitch, I can just build up faster my energies, and that was a really good one. So right now I'm in the final phase. We didn't see the second phase at all. So sometimes he just dies. He just dies. Before you know it, he's dead. Just for the record, for many of you who play this game for the very first time, you probably struggle a lot with many of these bosses. Usually people don't know about glitches and stuff like that, so it is quite tricky. There's a lot of...
Struggling is normal for this game, that's for sure.
Yeah. I really love this game because the developers, like, they got inspired on the difficulty. So, okay, here we have the King Dice. Let's see. Oh, yeah, this is King Dice.
Well, ain't that a beep?
Well,
Mr. King Dice.
Oh, wait, what I did? Well, actually, I have never tried, like, to exit door. But yeah, like, there is three islands that, I'm gonna continue with the story. So, the Moldenhauer brothers lose their souls to the devil, and then the devil told them, like, they can recover their souls if they collect the soul contracts or the soul debts from all these bosses or the people from the islands. So that's what I'm actually doing right now. So I'm collecting contracts, like I'm working for the devil at the moment. So that's not very good. And well, here, let me just throw that mark. I'm gonna hope to kill this boss fast. Usually you have to wait until this boss starts to move. To kill him. Oh, wow. I don't know.
Unbelievable.
She didn't do anything at all. Like, what the hell is going on?
You'll see these bosses have multiple phases, and if you're as fast as Tiamari's, you won't even see the third one.
Yeah, that's crazy. So there is one little bad thing about the weapon swap glitch. Sometimes if you throw a special attack while you're swapping, like frame perfect, it doesn't quite work. Hey, I want to talk to you. So this guy is going to give me some missiles. With those missiles, I'm going to be able to do the same weapon swap, but now in the airplane level. So this gym, it has a lot of faces, and I'm going to hit a hitbox that is off screen, right in the bottom. If I throw the bombs, I can hit the hitbox of that gym. So as you can see, like the cards are building up there. I'm hitting the boss off screen. I keep shooting those missiles there. Every missile is doing some damage to the boss, which is great for me. And because of that, I'm gonna be able to skip like the last phase of the boss. Well, not the last phase, but the very next phase. Like here after the coffin, he's supposed to make something else, but now he's not gonna do it. Also, there are certain hitboxes that you can abuse. Like I'm gonna try to stay close. You see, that thing didn't hit me. Ouch. That is the only problem. There is ghosts that can hit you. So I'm gonna use the super missile and take some advantage of the invincibility frames and hope that I can kill the boss fast enough. But sometimes you don't kill him.
Knockout.
That was it.
There's so much to know.
Yeah.
So much to know.
Okay, so this game, when it came out, like it was kind of simple, right? It was just one category, like in any speedrun. But
has it ever been simple?
Yeah, but then suddenly, like a lot of more categories started to to be burned.
Yeah,
to be burned. Oh, these barbershop guys are very sad.
Oh, I love those guys.
Yeah, the barbershop trio, they cannot find the fourth member, so we're gonna help those guys, like, later on. I really wanna make a good day today, because we're having a really amazing crowd in Las Vegas. Woo! Okay, I'm gonna try to do a glitch in this boss. Hopefully I can get it. So I need to make all the damage that I can as fast as possible and hope that he's not gonna do something. And you see those explosions there in the top of the screen? That means I got the glitch. And now the game is gonna get crazy. As I told you, I just overdamaged the boss in the first phase, and well, I need to be also careful to don't die. Okay, so I'm hitting all the faces that's supposed to be there. Just I did overdamage the boss, so that was it. That was it.
Oh my god! So much going on.
Yeah, basically those glitches happen by overdamaging. So this boss supposed to have four faces. And, well, in theory, I killed them, except that the second one didn't really show up at all, so it just started to go from the third and the fourth after. Everything just because of damage.
I should tell you, I don't know if Cuphead and Mugman have a last name. When you asked me, I thought you were talking about the developer's last name.
Well, no.
I was busy. I was watching a game.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I can't tell you. Well, I just find the fourth guy, so... Do you think it's time for a good song? Let's hear the song of these guys, hopefully. Okay. So, oh boy, you did it. They're gonna sing for us. So.
It's nice to rest your eyes and maybe
come on, guys.
Go
just wave your hands. Just wave your hands. It's a beautiful music right here.
Oh, look at this.
I love you guys. Thank you so much.
That's beautiful.
Yeah. Beautiful. Shout out to the barbershop. Yeah.
The barbershop part, are okay. So, we have more flying levels. Surprisingly for me, like, the flying levels are the hardest ones for me. It's just...
That's typical, I think.
Huh?
They are very difficult.
Yeah, they are. Okay. So in this one, you want to... Ouch. You don't get hit. Like, I wanted to kind of stay close, but he was too far up that it didn't let me quite do what I wanted. I mean, we're still good. So I'm gonna try to hold as long as I can to use that and take advantage of the invincibility frame. Then by pressing start, you trigger a little bit faster this last phase.
That's not nice.
So do we have actually any question from the crowd, like in here?
Yeah,
who's got a question? Somebody want to raise your hand if you got a question for Team R? You can walk it through. Anyone? Oh, I see some people.
Okay, well, meanwhile, I'm going to say about the categories. Like, there started to be many categories. Like, for example, there I got the grade B. Certain things you do with fighting the boss, it can give you a higher rank. Like not getting hit, like parrying three times, like shooting the specials. Like
hitting all the parries as well.
Yep. Yeah. Killing the boss fast enough. So I remember because I was using this glitch, a lot of people used to call me like a cheater on YouTube. And I was like, come on, guys, just give me a break. I know how to play the game. It's not like I'm cheating. It's just like the developers let me do this. I'm just doing it.
This level is so beautiful. This is one example of how hard they worked on the game. That castle in the background is actually a 3D model that they put in there. And it's just so much effort went in there. It's one of the things that makes it a masterpiece, in my opinion.
Hey, Timar, we got a question from the crowd, if you're ready.
Yeah.
We got Fernando here. Why don't you go ahead and ask your question.
Just wondering, like, how long you've been playing and how many hours a day, because this game's so difficult that I tried it and it's just impossible.
How many hours? Well, I think I have, like, 750, thanks to Steam that tells you how many hours you have in the game. I think it took me about 80 hours just to get to a good level that it was very easy to beat the game for me.
That's a lot of hours.
Sorry. It's still very difficult, the game. And I'm sweating here at the edge of my seat.
750 hours is around 31 days, if anyone's...
1 month? Wow.
Yes.
Yep. Just 1 month.
Just a month.
Just a month.
You got a month.
OK.
But with it,
reminder, folks, if you got any more questions, please feel free to wave us down. We'll be right over and give you some your chance to ask a question to TMR.
Yeah, here the King Dice is saying, oh, you're doing some good progress, right? I'm going to put some more difficult bosses.
Hey, boss, these guys are killing the bosses too fast. We have to slow them down.
Damn it, man. So I think they're going to add some extra bosses for this third island.
If you see these guys in the casino, don't talk to them.
Yeah, don't talk to them.
No.
They're bad guys. Okay.
I love this one.
So yeah, like every single boss feels very unique. Like they has their own animation. Like here you have like a police, I don't know if it's a bee ant or a flying ant. I don't know what it is, but yeah, you have this bee and it's possible to kill her fast enough. Let me just try to stop hitting her. So maybe I can kill her in the next phase. Hopefully it will just show in the middle. Yeah, that's what I want. So if you throw all your specials and the RNG manipulation is right, you can kill her right there with no problem.
So fast. I like the filing cabinets and the desks in the back because they're worker bees.
Yeah.
We got another question over here from the audience. John.
John. Hello, John. How are you?
Hi, big fan. Just had a question. What's your favorite part of the game?
What's my favorite part?
Favorite part, yeah.
I think I get some satisfaction by hearing the knockout because I just killed the boss and it just makes me feel like, oh, I did something good. I do like Calamaria boss. That is a very sexy boss. It definitely, I had a crush. and also the King Dice. I think that it was very creative. Well, here I'm going to try like a glitch in this one. I don't know if I'm going to get it. I'm just going to pray. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, I got it. So if you throw the second special, the one that has like the magnets, all that, you just overdamage the boss. Like this boss has like 3 faces. And yeah, that was a really nice one. It's a hard thing to pull off because the damage is not exactly, I mean, it's exactly the same, but the thing is each bullet is making some damage, and if you don't have the exact amount of damage, you might not get it, and it will trigger the next phase. But actually, it went pretty well.
It went very well. I spent a month playing that guy alone.
Yeah. Okay, so the game really has a lot of categories. You can play the game in expert mode once you beat the game in regular mode, which is the one that I'm currently playing. And yeah, I was telling you that the story about guys calling me a cheater, like, because, you know, the YouTube judges, they catch everything on speedrunners, right? Like, they know if you're cheating, they know that if you, I don't know, have a freaking a Skynet NES or whatever. So, because I was getting tired of those comments, I decided to create a category in this one that I call it the Hater Percent, in honor of those hate YouTube comments. So that Hater Percent is kind of having just a normal gun, not allowing to buy any weapon, and you just beat in the hardest difficulty, which is expert mode, also with this rank, and yeah.
That's a very difficult category. You can't have any damage in any bosses.
Yeah.
You have to do all running guns. It's very demanding.
It gets really hard. Yeah. After. So this game is full of little details. Like, for example, you have here a little guy that is called, I think this one is Beethoven and the other one is Mozart. Right here, it's like, oh, you talk to the other guy. Oh, yeah. This is Wolfgang, Mozart. So if you keep talking to them back and forth, like, for example, Beethoven is the guy who likes minimalist music, so less is better. And this guy is like, no, man. the more chords and noise you do is better. No, I'm telling you, less is better. So you just keep talking to these guys back and forth, and at a certain point you will trigger this. Basically, they remove the brass section. It's just the piano, the sexy piano. This is when you get closer to the girl, and you tell her, I like the way you look tonight. Okay.
Everything means something in this game. It's so great.
Yeah. Each boss has a specific name, but sometimes they're very similar to other things that I have watched. So I call this boss Tom and Jerry.
I wonder why.
Yeah, I'm wondering why. So I mean, I could be a little bit kind of careful with my health, but you know, you just, it's so powerful, the weapon switching, that you kill the bosses before they even attack. Oh wait, it was a rat all the time?
This whole time.
So,
yep. Good wait.
My beliefs are a lie, right?
Yep.
All I know is wrong.
Now we know.
Okay. So a few more bosses to go. Cuphead! But yeah, if you have any other question, where are you going? If you have any other question, feel free to ask me. I know I make look this game very trivial, but this is a boss that can give me a hard time.
This guy?
Yeah, because he can randomly just shoot you those bullets, or he can call like his partners, his helpers. So ideally you want him to call his helper. This time he called a shark. Daddy shark, daddy shark. And now I can see that I did enough damage, so I'm gonna just get rid of this guy, the octopus. So he's triggering the next phase, but usually you can kill him very fast, but I'm just gonna show you after, because there is some swag you can do. It looks really nice, it looks sick. You can parry this laser right here. I just did that for the swag, of course. So you can see a little bit more, right? Because otherwise you don't even see. But yeah, those pink things are parable. The timing for that jump is quite tricky. So I got lucky that I got it. But yeah, you see, we got an A.
Great A.
Yeah, perfect. Perfect grade.
Perfect student.
Perfect's all right.
Answering to the previous question of what I like about this game.
Here we are.
Here we are. Like this boss is so cool. I really love
Some
it.
Some of my favorite animations as well.
I'm not gonna spoil it. Look at this mermaid with an octopus as a hair. She's so cute. Like the way she moves, the way she dances.
Yeah, it's really great. Such affection went into this character.
Yeah, it's totally lovable. But every single boss, like, it's just so cool.
And that's the thing, when you have a boss that's that captivating. How are you supposed to watch the other things that are going on screen? So much. Yeah.
So, we did enough damage. Those eels are clearly transforming our lovely Calamaria into a, I don't know, like a snake. How do you pull this kind of Calamaria?
I'd say Medusa, but it's an octopus,
well, I'm just gonna show you, like actually she can stun you. I'm just gonna wait until she attacks, like, with a laser or something. Come on.
That's super scary.
You see, I turned into a stone. Ouch.
So yeah, a lot of Medusa in there as well. The one octopus leg is playing the violin.
Oh yeah,
like too bad.
TMR, I got a question for you. What would you say is the hardest boss in this game? For you, in the speedrun?
Yeah, I guess it depends on the difficulty. Because, for example, this one, you can see that it comes to a point that a lot of bosses are not extremely challenging. But trying to kill them fast in a speedrun is the way to go. So there's many technical bosses. For example, this boss, like in the second phase, if you start attacking too fast, sometimes you don't get the one cycle on the second phase, and that is gonna cost you time. So what is the hardest boss? It's hard for me to tell, because it depends on the category, and for each category it will be a very different boss.
Well, what about this category, the all bosses category?
Yeah, no. They're all easy for him. That's why he can't.
Yeah, he's
like No. It's not like that. All of them are easy. Well, you see, like, for example, that is the problem. Like, you wanna play at the edge, like doing damage boosts and stuff like that, in order to hit a little bit more the boss. The only problem is that, like, right now that I don't have health, I cannot play risky anymore, and I'm in a big chance to die. So I'm gonna try to don't die, but. Yeah, I just I don't know. It's just, well, you can play safe in a speedrun scenario. Like, you don't want to play safe. You just want to go as fast as you can. Lucky for me, I didn't die in this boss. I was close, right? That 1 HP flashing white and red is not very good. I think like a lot of flying bosses are really hard. For example, the genie one.
Oh yeah.
That one is a very tricky one because you wanna keep doing damage in the very bottom of the screen. So yeah.
It's almost like an auto scroller, you know, like it kind of keeps moving the screen with each phase.
But in that specific scenario, since you can hit the boss, it's not an auto scroller. Well, I mean. It is like you have to wait for all that phase.
Yeah.
Finally, we made it. Like, oh, well, look here. You actually pulled it off. You have made me lose a bet. So this guy actually was not rooting for us. And you know what happens to the guys that don't root for us, right?
The house always wins.
The house always wins. So in here, I'm going to go to the number 2. So this is the King Dice. And yeah, we're in Vegas, baby. We're in Vegas. We came just here to show you how to use your stuff. So in here, I'm gonna just run twice, and you can hit this guy by shooting off. Of course, you want to be attacking all the time as close as possible. And that was cool.
That was good.
So my strategy here is just trying to keep health, so later on I can just get hits and not care. Well, it's not like not care, it's actually faster, like in the very last phase of this boss.
Are you trying to give us some tips here on what to go use out at the tables?
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, like the usual tip is don't die, right? Don't get hit.
That's not a bad tip.
Yeah. Going with confidence.
I got a fun fact for you, TMR, if you didn't know. According to the developers, this domino, the man and the woman of it, are actually a married couple.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I can see the love they have, right?
That's affectionate, yeah.
Married couple, nice. I didn't know about that. But
I didn't either yet.
I want to say, like, the developers of the game, they have been putting attention to speedrunners, to people like me playing this game. Oh, I'm going to show you a pretty cool glitch.
This is also their first game, too.
Yeah. And very amazing game.
Very impressive.
So there is a huge glitch here. Like, when I flip two cards, the monkey changes his trajectory. So if I scroll the screen, then I send it off screen, and he just dies.
That's unbelievable.
Yeah, that's... Actually, it was first try. That was good. That was good. Not gonna lie. So finally, we made it to the very last, to the very last one. So I'm just gonna try to hit. So usually, you're supposed to parry those things, but as I told you, well, it didn't matter anymore. So I can take the hit, and boom. We just defeated the King Dice.
Really good.
The soundtrack of this game is one of the best things in a video game. It's so cool.
It's amazing. They brought in live musicians to record.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Another A. That's great. That's great.
Hey.
Especially that King Dice. There's a song. I'm Mr. King Dice, and it's so cool. So finally we get to the devil. One hell of a time, huh? And we indeed are having one hell of a time.
Well, well, well. Look how far you have gone. Not only did you bust up my good for nothing lucky King Dice, but I see you got my soul contract as agreed. Hand them over or and join my team.
What shall I say to him, guys? Shall I? Okay, sorry. Once again.
Was that a lot of no's where you're in?
One more time, what should he say?
Okay, how many says yes? Okay, how many says no?
There we go.
Okay, I guess no
wins.
Don't do it.
King Dice, you have been bad. I sentence you to die.
All right, who's excited for the final boss?
Yeah.
Yep.
Everybody?
This guy is no joke.
Yeah, so... Yeah, it has a lot of different attacks. Here in the very first phase, well, I just try to hit as much as I can. This is a very good RNG, because I got one thing to parry, then I can just keep on hitting the boss, which is pretty cool. Now I trigger the second phase of the boss, And right here, we proceed to the second phase. So if you do that pause, you're able like to move before actually you can. So it's just a little time saver. Not a big deal, but a little time saver. So the boss is gonna die very, very, very quick.
This is beautiful.
Yeah, it just, it's so powerful, the weapon swap glitching.
Yeah. I'm gonna, yes.
Boom.
That's it?
There it is, knockout!
The king dies, just die. Oh no, it's the devil, sorry. So right after you, well, I mean, by the way, it's time, usually for the speed runs.
Look at that.
We got the A.
Yeah.
Everything was perfect. So sometimes the game just doesn't give you the 2 stars because it feels like...
That wasn't good enough.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that was good enough. Reset. So the brothers tramp over the demon and everybody is happy. They have a really nice ending. And that was Cuphead. That was
That's
really Cuphead.
Thanks, let's hear it one more time for TMR.
Yeah, thank you, guys. Thank you. You have been such an amazing crowd. Like, really. It would have not been the same without you.
TMR, how do you feel about that low 33 time, I think? Pretty good?
Man, did I die? I didn't die. So how do I feel? I feel great. I didn't die.
That was deathless, yeah.
Yeah, that was deathless. So how do I feel? I feel good.
Feel fucking good, man?
I feel fucking good, man.
That's right. Hey, who else out there is feeling fucking good, yeah? You know, one or two. One or two people.
Anyway.
All right, well, with that, I think we're going to let Team R go ahead and get set up for our next run here. Pulling out a different controller. Got to get the Battletoads ready. You excited for Battletoads?
You need the real thing, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,